If you look at the shadows in this scene, you can see they are completely black. This is typically not what reality looks like. As an example, the floor under your desk is typically not completely black, even if no light from any specific lamp is hitting it directly. The classic hack for working around completely black shadows is the flat ambient light. It basically means adding a constant color to all pixels. As you can see, the shadows are no longer black, but still, they look flat. As an example, you can't even see where the edge between the wall and the floor is in the shadow. Adding a constant color like this doesn't simulate how light behaves in reality. You wouldn't be able to buy a lamp behaving like this at IKEA. Let's see if we can do better. So how do light behave in real life? When you look at the point in the scene, what is it you actually see? It's the light from the light source being reflected into your eyes. But only a fraction of the light reflected from a surface is actually going into your eyes. This bounced or indirect light is a big contribution of light in a scene. Let's enable simulation of it. Now the shadows look much more interesting. What's really going on is that light hitting a surface is being reflected back into the scene. This light can then be reflected back again and again. Since the walls absorb light with each bounce, each secondary bounce is weaker than the previous one. You can also see how the light hitting the red wall is being reflected back into the scene as red light. This is what we call color bleeding, and it happens because the red wall absorbs all but the red components of the light bouncing off it. To properly simulate indirect lighting for complex scenes can be very time consuming. Single frames of high quality rendering can literally take hours and even days. This wraps up the ambient and indirect light part. Thanks for listening.